Roger Stone says there's a demonic portal on top of the White House that he did not open. It magically appeared after Biden became president. Now, he's desperately trying to get to the White House in order to return home. He didn't add that last part. I put that last part in, but here it is.
When you're talking about the supernatural, there are a lot of people that go, oh, I don't know, that sounds weird to me. You were talking about something extraordinary. And I just love you to touch on that subject, because sure, it's at least very interesting.
I think that there has that a portal, a demonic portal, opened above the White House around the time that the Bidens moved in. This was brought to my attention by a Christian who lives in North Florida, who sent me a bunch of photographs and a bunch of documents, and also some notations in the Bible about portals. And I was like, okay, sure, okay, appreciate it. Thank you.
Well, I mean, you should start out by being skeptical. I was saying that sounds insane to me.
Exactly what I did.
But please continue.
So I was skeptical about it, but I looked at the photos, and you can also, there's a live cam where you can actually see in real time, and there does appear to be something, you know, above the White House.
Something inexplicable.
Well, at first you say, well, maybe it's a reflection, or maybe it's an aerostat balloon, you know, maybe there's a logical, so I called a police officer I know.
That's right. When you see demonic portals, it's time to call an officer that you know, a beat cop that patrols the street looking for demonic portals, obviously. All of us don't have such a personal hand, but Roger Stone does. Here's what happened.
Works in Arlington, he's a friend of mine. And I said, look, do me a favor, would you go down and check this out? He said, are you out of your mind? I said, no, just humor me. Go down there and check it out and tell me what, call me back and tell me what you see.
Right.
And take photos. And he called me back about 2.5 hours later and he said, you're not gonna believe this, but there's definitely something there, and it's there. He said, other people were there photographing it. One man called and said, you can see it day or night. It's like a smudge in the sky, almost like a cloud that doesn't move. But when you zoom in on it with a telephonic lens, it's swirling like a cauldron.
Now, wait a minute. So this is like, what, 8 months ago?
Yes.
Okay, so this is a cop.
Yes.
Telling you that he doesn't know what the heck it is, but
it's something.
But yeah, there's something there.
Correct.
And therefore, has this persisted?
Yes, it's still there.
It's still there.
It's still there.
Okay, that's nuts. Like, how has the media not covered this?
Well, the media doesn't cover a lot of things that are true.
But damn it, I'm covering it because it's true that Roger Stone said there's a portal, a demonic portal on top of the White House. Now, here's the thing. Republicans always jump to conclusions. Why does it have to be a demonic portal? Why can't it be an entry into Middle Earth, or perhaps the fourth, possibly fifth dimension? Or what about the Greys? How do the Greys feel about this conclusion that you all have decided to reach without consultation with anyone? All right, also Ron DeSantis, the governor of Florida. Well, his friend ended up dead in extremely mysterious circumstances. Let me go to this story. Let's put up the picture of his friend. All right, so this is going to be an interesting and also baffling story. The super donor to the governor of Florida and a Jacksonville defense contractor, Kent Sturman, apparently took his own life, according to the reports. This took place Thursday outside of Mayport Post Office after an investigation was launched into his alleged sexual misconduct. Now, there are some dynamics worthy of examination. Sturman is the owner of Total Military Management, had donated more than $60,000 directly to the election of DeSantis, and was appointed by the governor to serve on the Board of Governors. That is the organization which oversees state universities. Jacksonville Sheriff T.K. Waters told the Florida Times Union, and I quote, this investigation remains ongoing at this time and will continue until its completion. As with all active investigations, there is limited information available to release at this time. However, As soon as this investigation has been completed, all applicable information will be available for release to the public. Now, already there seems to be a conflict in the information. One narrative says he took his own life. The other one says this is an active and ongoing investigation to reach a conclusion as to what happened. DeSantis moved into a condominium owned by Mr. Sturman in a newly drawn congressional district after he was pushed out of his own district in 2016 by redistricting. The 50-year-old Sturman has suffered a stroke last week and was released from the hospital on the day he died. And he claimed at the time that he was actually leaving politics. There's more. Sturman told Florida Politics at the time, and I quote, "I am stepping about as far from politics as I can right now. My prognosis is positive. And I just got discharged from the hospital, but I have a ton of work to do to get healthy." Now, that doesn't sound like an individual who's about to commit suicide hours later. Sounds like someone who's looking forward to having a different kind of life. Maybe a person who has figured some things out. Maybe someone who knows something and he's deciding to get away from politics, which means what? He's getting away from Ron DeSantis. Now, I'm not saying there's a correlation, but definitely there's something not on the record that should be. All right, my dear brother, what are your thoughts here?
Well, first of all, let me say that to the normal, sane people in Florida, I wish you luck.
Right.
Because
that's all we can do.
These stories are continually coming out of Florida. This whole Roger Stone thing with, you know, a North Florida person told him that there's a demonic portal above the White House, and then he sent a cop to look at it, and they've seen it and this and that. Now, I don't know about you, Doc, but I saw both of them on camera. Why didn't they show us a picture of the demonic portal on camera? See, I mean,
exactly.
They said it's still there, and they're sitting there. It's like, hey, let us in on it. And this goes back to part of the manipulation of the Republican cult, right, is religious. And they make up these religious claims. And it's unfortunate because they take advantage of the least educated, the most vulnerable people, right? The people who will believe this kind of thing. And they'll believe anything negative you can say about Biden or any Democrat or whatever. And then, you know, it's so that part of it's unfortunate. It would be comical if it wasn't a con.
Yep.
You know. The guy donating money to DeSantis and all, this is a tough one, right? Because again, without jumping to conclusions, and that's what conspiracy theorists, I always say that I love conspiracy theorists because they believe in humanity. They always believe a large group of people can work together and keep a secret.
That's true.
I've been around people too long to know that. But so I don't want to jump into that. But it does look kind of shaky that this guy's about to be investigated for sexual allegations or something like that. And then he just apparently kills himself. Without knowing what's going on in the investigation, it looks bad. The fact that he's friends with DeSantis, that he's given DeSantis a bunch of money, and DeSantis is living, well, he was living in a condo that the guy owned or the guy yes. built or something like that. Yeah, it's, you'd think, I guess maybe he thought he had cover. Maybe he was doing some dirt and figured, hey, I'm friends with the governor. The governor will cover me on this, and somebody at the governor's office said no, or maybe, like you said, it doesn't sound like the day that somebody's ready to commit suicide. But without a real investigation into this, who knows? Again, it's another Florida story. You know, there's probably an alligator involved somewhere, and you know, maybe aliens from outer space. I mean, these Florida stories just keep going.
I'm waiting for that demonic portal to open up on top of the DeSantis house so he can take his ass back home.
Exactly. All right.